So we're going to get started. If you would come on in and grab a seat, that would be great. Come on in and grab a seat. This is great. What a great turnout. When we're trying to figure out how many seats to set up, we take a guess. And it looks like we're almost right. So just a welcome this morning to all of you that are here and for the efforts that you've made to come from wherever you've come from. So welcome families of students, LTD students and Trailhead. This is a great day and you've come to celebrate. We appreciate that. And thank you for friends also, not just family, for coming. Thanks also to Forest Springs staff that are here who have been a part of this for 9 months or a year. Thanks for coming and being a part of this celebration. A special welcome to guests that have come pretty far, like particularly our staff from Cedar Bay, like the Pearsons and Johnny Hofflin. Where's Johnny? Johnny, thanks for coming. I'm sure he wants to come up and say something. Thanks to the Aldrich family, Noel Aldrich family, one of our board members that's here. And Pat Petka's here. We didn't expect him. He had other things that he and Karen were needing to do today, but Pat's here. So welcome to Pat, our executive director as well. This is a special day. And I was telling my wife this morning that we've got sometimes in life to stop and celebrate something. So not move on so quickly, stop, celebrate. And when you celebrate, you want to look back, you want to take account of things, you want to remember things. And so this is a special day of celebration. Today is the graduation of the 48th LTD class. So we've been doing LTD for 48 years. And this group joins of about 360 graduates that they'll be a part of. And this is also the 11th Trailhead graduation. I know Dan and I think about this. Maybe sometimes it feels like 11 years has been a long time. Other times, 11 years, it's incredibly how fast that's gone. And I'm guessing, Dan, about 115, 120 graduates through the Trailhead program. Pretty amazing. So today's a celebration of accomplishment. Every student has been challenged in one way or another to write, to read, to interact with theology, to interact with biblical truth, to interact with stuff in their lives, and lots of other challenges that have been in front of the students. And so today we celebrate accomplishment. We also want to celebrate transformation. And I know all of you would agree with this. It's important to stop and celebrate what God has done in people's lives. Whenever you're around that is worth celebrating. Trailhead, I know that God's worked in your lives. You've read scripture and the Spirit's moved in your lives. And LTD, same thing. Transformation has happened this year, and we want to celebrate that. It's true for Trailhead, and it's also true for LTD. I'm celebrating that you guys have taken a year to prepare yourselves for what God has next for you. Trailhead, you've done this. You've spent a year preparing. You're not sure what the next year brings, and if you look on the back of your program, you'll see, don't do it now, but you could look later. There's a description there of what everybody's heading to next. And so today we celebrate this year or 9 months of preparation that everybody has put into this. From the staff here at Forest Springs, Trailhead and LTD, thank you for your service this year. Guests, we probably could not add up how many hours of service this group of amazing people have done here to serve our guests. Week in, week out, guests come and go, and when new guests come here, they find this place clean and ready, and that takes a lot of work, and this group of people needs a lot of thanks for all their many, many hours of service that they've put in here. So give them a quick round of applause. Thank you for your service. I was going to say, that's a lot of shovelfuls of snow, but that's not true this year. Okay. Special thanks to Dan Jacobson for all that he's done for Trailhead this year, and Laura that supports him. Thanks to Trailhead RAs, Ben and Kat, they're here. Thank you to them. Special thanks to the staff that have been in the classroom teaching or mentoring or paper mentors. There's a lot of people to thank that have made this year go well that way. Thanks to all of you, parents, cousins, relatives, and all the support that you have offered the students this year. Appreciate that. Special thanks to my wife, Allison, who's right over here. I spend a lot of time here at camp and a lot of time on trips and wherever with students and teaching. Just to acknowledge, probably none of that would happen without my wife's support. So Allison, thank you for her encouragement. Yep. And the LTD students know too that occasionally or frequently I get correction and direction from my wife as well. Want to just acknowledge Dick Angelo's here. I didn't see Viv, but I know Dick is here. Dick Angelo, who's retired from Forest Springs after serving here 150 years, is what he would say. But you look at the LTD program in its 48th year. It was a vision that God gave Dick Angelo many, many years ago, and I think it's important this morning to look back in history to see where all of this has come from. So Dick, thank you for being here today and being a part of this celebration. Again, thanks Pat for being here too. Lastly, John Clausen, who's our camp director, couldn't be here today, and I was giving him a hard time about it. It's like, you're the director. Like, how could you not be here? And his real tension is that his daughter, Alyssa, is graduating from college today as well. So we said, no, you need to go to Emmaus Bible College and be there for her graduation. But in the middle of this time, John has a prayer that he does for the students. So when the video's on, that's John Clausen. He's our director, and we're glad he is where he is. So let me pray and open this time. Father, we are grateful today for this time of celebration. And Lord, we do intentionally want to slow down and notice what you've done and give you praise and glory for it. May this be a time of celebration. May it be a time of memory. And may it be a good time where the year and the times that we've spent together, they end today. Fittingly, that we celebrate and give you the praise and glory for this. So I thank you for each one of these students and the role that they've played, and even as we listen to the worship team, helping us turn our eyes to Jesus. And Lord, we thank you that this year it's been about you, Lord. It's been about Jesus. That the accomplishments are that each one of us, students included, have tried to focus more clearly on who Jesus is as the scriptures reveal him, and that the rest of our lives, that would be true about us, that we'd be found pursuing Jesus. And that's really what we wanted to accomplish, and we thank you that that has been achieved. So thanks again for this time. In Jesus' name, amen.
Giving glory to the one who deserves it all, right? So, as Norm said, you can listen to us, but we'd love for you to sing with us. So go ahead and stand up, and we're gonna celebrate this morning.
The night, wanting a place to hide this weary soul, this bag of bones. And I tried with all my might, but I just can't win the fight. I'm slowly drifting, a vagabond. Just when I ran out of road, I met a man I didn't know, and he told me that I was not alone. He picked me up and turned me around and placed my feet on the solid ground. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, because he healed my heart. He changed my name, forever free, I'm not the same. I thank the Master, I thank the Savior, I thank God. I cannot deny what I see, got no choice but to believe. My doubts are burning like ashes in the wind. So long. bitterness, you can't just keep it moving. Nah, you ain't welcome here. From now till I walk the streets of gold, I'll sing of how you saved my soul. This wayward son has found his way back.
Okay, today I'm going to be reading from Hebrews 11:39 through 12:7. And all these, having gained approval through their faith, did not receive what was promised, because God had provided something better for us, so that apart from us, they would not be made perfect. Therefore, since we have so great a cloud of witnesses surrounding us, let us also lay aside every encumbrance and the sin which so easily entangles us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, fixing our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who, for the joy set before him, endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. For consider him who has endured such hostility by sinners against himself, so that you will not grow weary or lose heart. You have not yet resisted to the point of shedding blood in your striving against sin, and you have forgotten the exhortation which is addressed to you as sons. My son, do not regard lightly the discipline of the Lord, nor faint when you are reproved by him. For those whom the Lord loves, he disciplines, and he scourges every son whom he receives. It is the discipline that you endure. God deals with you as with sons. For what son is there whom his father does not discipline?
Hello, everyone, and thank you so much for being here. My name is Paul, and this is Abby, and we get the pleasure of sharing a little bit of what our LTD year has been with you guys and here at camp and together with our classmates. We started off the LTD year. It's kind of like when you get a random roommate in college. It's people that you're going to live with for the rest of the year, and you get probably the best photo that they can submit, and then a little bit about them, and that's it. So then you're told you're going to do life together for a year. Starting off in orientation, it was three married couples, and so we got to bond in that way really quickly. It was very unique for us, for this class. One thing right away during orientation, we spend about a week just getting to know each other, camp, and going through some challenges together just to grow. But we managed to convince Norm to let us borrow the LTD van so we could go to Wausau together just to escape for just a little bit.
Okay, one of the things we did, that we haven't practiced this, oh yeah, I'm like, whoa. So if I say something dumb. One of the things we did was low ropes and basically just like a on-the-ground challenge course, which was a lot of fun, but also kind of stressful because we didn't really know each other. So one of the things was we all went and got blindfolded and stood on a log and were supposed to completely switch our order or something while blindfolded.
I got a little frustrated with that one, and I picked up Tim Burkholder and just moved him from my right side to my left. Another challenge we were able to do right away was a high ropes course, just something to really break the ice as a group. And it's challenging. I mean, it's very high in the air, and a lot of us are not comfortable with heights. and so it was a challenge at first. And honestly, what I was most nervous about was at the end, there's a giant swing, and your friends are still strapped up to the top of the tower, and then you go on the swing. I thought I was going to shake the tower so bad that they were just going to fall off and be dangling there with their safety lines, which is why Abby went first.
Yeah, so the only good thing about high ropes was that the mosquitoes don't mostly get that high, so yeah. But yeah, the mosquitoes were really bad this summer. That lived up to expectation and exceeded it. So that was miserable. But, you know, yeah. So four of us, Tim and Ashley and me and Daniel, stayed here at Forest Springs, Westboro, for our summer. High adventure. Ashley did a lot of things. I don't know. She was everywhere. And I was mostly in the kitchen. So, and then Paul and Carly.
Carly and I had a different summer from the rest of our class. We had 2 weeks of getting to know each other and feeling like we were finally connecting, and then Carly and I went back to Cedar Bay in the UP, where we were previously on staff, and we were finishing up a summer there. And it was a new challenge. I was put in a different position than I had been doing all year, and so it was cool. But the one thing that really connected us together through that time, even though we were 6.5 hours apart by driving, was every Sunday we would FaceTime as a group and pray together and just reflect on our week and pray for the upcoming week.
So once the summer is over, Paul and Carly came back and rejoined our group, and pretty shortly we went on a canoe trip as the LTD class with Norm and Brittany. Me and Daniel had been on one during the summer, and I already knew I hated it, but, you know. So we did it again. But, yeah, so at one point, me and Daniel got to be in a canoe together, which we thought was going to be a lot of fun for the whole day. I think that was probably the hardest day that we had overall, as being couples in canoes. But yeah, so we did that. And, you know, so there's one point where you're like, there's kind of almost a lake, and then you wait to go down the rapids. So we're taking them one at a time. So if somebody, you know, flips over, they can save them before the next one goes. But so we're like drifting around and kind of waiting up top for somebody else to go. And apparently Daniel was like getting real mad because I was like, you know, pushing us this way and then pushing us that way. And it was like, oh my goodness. So then we go down the rapids and you go between the different rocks. Like, you know, you're, yeah, trying not to hit the rocks, obviously. But so we make it the whole way through. And at the end, there's, I think one of the adventure trips was like doing the raps at the same time of us with their group. So one of the guys is standing on a rock right here. It's like real obvious where the rock is. Like you can go this way or you can go that way. And we both tried to go different ways. So we come to the rock and we hit it just like, we're like, meek, and it stopped right there. It was a little bit of a fight. It was pretty funny in hindsight. But yeah, that was a good memory from that.
Brittany and I started our canoe trip off together, sharing a canoe, and the river was pretty low by the end of the summer. It had been pretty hot out, so the water was pretty low. And we had a lot of things on our canoe, so it was very heavy, and we just kept grounding out on gravel bars. So when people ask how the canoe trip was, I say it was a very nice walk, because we walked our canoe most of the first day.
Yeah, and then one of the days we were together in a canoe, which actually turned out pretty well. We did great, mostly because he was in the back, so he could both steer and paddle, and I was in the front and also mostly out of the water. So that went really well. It was a pretty good trip, ended pretty well. So, yeah.
Shortly after that canoe trip, which was just a good way for us to reconnect after the summer, talk about our summer, we got to do... Part of LTD is we go on these camp tours. We get to see how different camps operate, not just Four Springs and not just the four sites under Four Springs Ministries, but other camps that are in Wisconsin and Minnesota. So we got to go first out to eastern Wisconsin, to Honey Rock and Fort Wilderness, and really just got to know each other more on those trips and had a good time. When we went to the western side of the state, we went to Grantsburg and Frederick for Oak Forest and Wood Lake, and then we went to Arrowhead on the way there. But we got to work together a little bit, and unfortunately, when we were at Oak Forest, I had gotten sick, and we were planning on doing work projects, and there was another camp that the rest of LTD went to that I unfortunately was sick in bed and couldn't go to. And I wish we had sent this photo to Ashley to put it up on the screen, but they took a photo, a group photo, and then Carly had, my wife, had her arm out so they could Photoshop me in, and we never did. So it's just a photo with just me not in it, and they look like it could be me in it.
Okay, one of the most notable things, well, other than the camps, about our camp tours and drives literally anywhere is that Norm has to stop for his coffee. So if we like Dunkin', great. If we don't, great, we win anyways. But yeah. One of the other fall things that was notable is that we, as an LTD class, planned a marriage retreat a couple of weeks. We did, well, they chose the speaker for us, but we chose the theme and the decor and, like, the workshops and all that. So it was something that was really fun to work as all six of us together and plan that. But, yeah. Next. Oh, yeah. So I'm from Nebraska, so we think... Thank you. We think we get some pretty good snow down over there, which we get a lot. Anyways, so we came up here and was like, the snow is going to be horrible. We Nebraskans/Iowans were not prepared for it. We're going to die. All the shoveling, and we got, what, like two snows and shoveled like four times, and several of them we really didn't need to. So, yeah, the snow was not. Yeah.
Part of that is... one of the LTD students is put in charge of snow shoveling for the LTD and Trailhead, doing that together, as well as a couple of winter staff. And that was Daniel, who had expressed the most interest in shoveling snow and wanting to just do the work. So, of course, they put him in charge so he'd be floating around and not actually shoveling. There was a couple times where there was days where we got like a dusting, and so he was like, all right, no shoveling. And then we'd see him outside later just shoveling by himself because he wanted to. Didn't get nearly enough snow for him. Something else we got to do, we get to learn how to ski or relearn how to ski in the case of Tim and I. And then we instruct beginner ski lessons on our hill outside across the lake here for the campers and families that are coming in. So when we were learning, Abby was having a little bit of trouble just starting. She's a great skier now. She's fantastic. But she was just starting, and I didn't know if she was going to be having a good day or not. And so... just the whole time, I'm just sitting next to her, and I'm just fake falling down the hill a little bit, just trying to make her laugh so she at least have a good day. She was actually falling down. And then the first day was when we were really relearning how to ski. Tim and I and a couple others followed our instructor, who was going to take us up to the top of the ski hill, and he said, there's a nice blue we can do. He lied. There was only black diamonds up there. And so he goes down, and our instructor, it's his first skiing of the year, of the season, and so he almost eats it going down, but he manages to stay up. Ben, who is one of the Trailhead RAs, he goes, and then he just tumbles down. Tim, who's with him, he goes, and then he falls down. I make it half a foot down this hill, and then I fall on my back and penguin slide down the rest of the hill. And during that, I ended up butt dialing my dad. Yeah. As our year came towards the spring, we got the opportunity to go to a few more camps, and we went with Trailhead to some camps in Minnesota to do some work trips to see how they operate, but also to serve them in small ways. So it was really fun. I mean, we got to our first camp, Covenant Pines, Minnesota, and the trailer had ended up breaking in a small way. And so Tim and a few other guys are in the shop, and they're welding the trailer back together that had all of our stuff in it, trying to weld the axle for a temporary repair so we can at least continue our trip and then get back home without leaving just everything scattered across the highway. And then Norm and I got to dock some trees that they had cut down so we could split. And it was just a really great time of serving together with the Trailhead too. Something that Graham and I had done, he, one of the Trailhead students, he and I were de-waxing some floors at a different camp. And they had a ping pong table stacked on top of a pool table. And so we invented the game Elevated Ping Pong, where, for me, I mean, it's like about here, you know, so it's not too bad. And then we had Tim play, and Tim, and you can't even see him. So we have Tim and Ashley play each other, and they're the same height. So they're just, where'd the ball go? Yeah. Something else was we went to 3CA, which is the Christian Camp and Conference Center Association. They have different sectionals for camps and conference centers, Christian camps, to get together and connect the staff. And it's a really cool support for different ministries. So LTD got to go to two different sectionals. We went to Minnesota for their mini Dakota, so a bunch of camps in Minnesota and the Dakotas. And then we went to the Wisconsin one. And that was just a really cool opportunity because it's towards the end of the year. We've kind of all figured out as students what we want to be doing. And they give you the opportunity to go to different breakouts with people who are doing what, you know, like maybe there's a maintenance breakout or a kitchen or office staff or guest services, those different kind of program. And so we got to connect with different people from different camps and make some good relationships outside of Forest Springs. But something that was really fun from that was the first night we were in Minnesota, everybody, all the LTD were playing some games with people, having fun, and two girls ended up bringing their Switch to play Mario Kart. And my wife loves Mario Kart, so she sheepishly went over to them to ask if she could play, and then proceeded to beat them in every single race, just one after another.
So as family of LTD, you're probably aware that the LTD class works on like a large project with basically designing and writing an entire very long paper, if you write a lot, on basically like a dream camp. So like something where you can really see yourself working. So like you could do it just like a normal kids camp or whatever ministry that fits into that you could see yourself working in. So that was something that we spent a lot of time working on, especially in the last couple of months. But yeah, so after we wrote that, we got it printed and put together by Brittany and then presented it as our kind of our final thing. So
some people were trying to get bonus points, and Norm grew up in Africa and he's a huge fan of lions, and so one of our classmates decided to put a lion on every single slide of his presentation. But for wrapping up our year, I mean, it was a huge learning experience for all of us. We were all pushed in ways that we did not expect to be pushed. We were instructors, we were students. We had a lot of homework, but we had a lot of time together as well. What's really cool is that as we are leaving this site and going out, two of the six are staying here, planning on staying here. Two are staying within the ministry, and then my wife and I are going to another camp. So that, I mean, we're all staying in camping ministry, which is just a fantastic time. And we're looking forward to connecting again at different 3CAs. Thank you guys so much for your time.
Good morning. My name is Dan. I'm the director of Trailhead.
and I just want to let you know what you're about to hear. Our students have learned a lot of different things this year, but if you would look at what 8 months of Trailhead is like, one of the key things they've learned about is themselves. They have made some good friends, and they have found out where they might bug their roommate if they're not careful. They've done assessments that have shown them things about their own personalities. Of course, they've been in God's Word, and they've learned what God's Word says about them. And so they get to the end of the year, and we have them write what we call an identity statement or an I am statement. And it's kind of just pulling all of that data together and putting it into a little document, just one page. This is where I'm at in my life, and this is what I am pronouncing, in a sense, over myself from God's Word. And they've all done this, so if you're connected to a Trailhead student, you can ask them, but they don't have to let you read it. I think I told you guys that. Some of these are personal, you know, but I think if you twist their arm enough, they might read them to you. We've got two of them. Brady and Ember are going to share. And Brady is our youngest believer, I think, in the group at, what, maybe 2 years? And I'm proud of you, Brady, for doing this morning. Ember's been a believer longer, but she's been learning this year as well, and she's going to share. So, Brady, you can come up, and then Ember, you can just come up when Brady's done.
Hi, I'm Brady. That's better. Well, yeah, like Dan said, we've been working on our I am statements, and all of us did it. All of us did a really good job, I think. I'm proud of all of you. I was just asked to read mine. So let's just dive into it. All right. I am okay. I know that statement doesn't sound like much, but let me explain. I grew up in a household where God wasn't talked about too much. My parents made the decision that they wanted their children to find their own way in life. As I grew up, I believed in the existence of God, but I knew next to nothing about him. When COVID happened, I developed depression and anxiety, and at one point, I had lost all hope that it would get better. It went on for a few years, and because of that, high school wasn't always super easy to handle. I experienced my first panic attack. I experienced the temptation to start doing drugs. I experienced a lot of pain and struggle. Junior year, when a friend invited me to a youth rally one night at a church close to my current one. I had no idea God would call me to him. That was 2 years ago, and the change I've undergone since that night is amazing. God helped me to realize that I am loved, I am valuable, and I am his. And as Psalm 139 says, I am fearfully and wonderfully made. I'm reminded of a parable from Luke 7:41-43. Jesus said, a certain moneylender had two debtors. One owed 500 denarii and the other 50. When they could not pay, he canceled the debt of both. Now which of them will love him more? Simon, one of the apostles, answered, the one, I suppose, for whom he canceled the larger debt. And he said to him, you have judged rightly. God has forgiven me of so many things that I once thought unforgivable. He has washed me clean of the sins of my past, and I'm so grateful, and I love him so much for it. My mental health struggles got a bit easier to handle over time after becoming a Christian, but they were still very prevalent. When senior year came, I engaged in a lot of delinquent behavior, I guess. Some of it that wasn't even legal. Some of it that was just harmless but kind of reckless fun. Then summer came, and after graduating high school, I wasn't really sure what to do. I got a bit more involved with my church. I started learning about God more. I strengthened and even made new friendships at my church, but my mental struggles were still persistent, and I got accepted for Trailhead. Leaving home for the first time was a difficult step, but it was something I felt God was calling me to do. When I look back on the first day, I remember how anxious I was. After my mom left from dropping me off, I knew nobody and nothing about the camp. I didn't know what to do. But that didn't really last long. Over the months in Trailhead, I've learned so much about myself. I am now a brother to a bunch of people I didn't know existed a year ago. I'm a friend, and I try my best to make everyone feel comfortable and welcome. It took a while for me to get accustomed to life at Forest Springs. I expected it to be a big change, but I'm not sure if I was prepared for it. Getting up before 10 o'clock wasn't something I was used to after a summer of doing pretty much nothing. The work taught me how to find the strength to get out of bed even when I really didn't want to, which is something I'm grateful for even if I'm still not great at it. I got to experience the feeling of having older brothers for the first time. God has helped me to start viewing myself in a better light and also blessed me with the chance to get my learner's permit and start driving. God's work here has helped me realize that I am capable of much more than I once thought possible. I am valuable in the eyes of God and in the eyes of everyone around me. Even as I have lost friends from my Christian views, this family that I've found has helped me to realize that God is teaching me important things through the pain I've endured. Pain I've endured due to the strength He has given me. I am often not strong enough to deal with things thrown my way, but God is. Psalm 73 says, "My flesh and my heart may fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever." Now that Trailhead is ending, I'm nervous about what plans God has in store for me. Just in the past few weeks, He's been presenting challenges in front of me that have been very difficult to navigate. Part of me feels like I'm not ready to leave this place, but I know that God is with me wherever I go. I am His. When I was deep in the mental struggles I mentioned earlier, I didn't see the light at the end of the tunnel. When someone asked me if I was doing okay, I'd often reply saying yes. But inside I knew that I hadn't been okay in a long time. I didn't think that I would make it out of that. I didn't think God noticed me. I had no idea of the work He would do in me. Now at the end of Trailhead, I can honestly look at myself and rejoice, because thanks to the Lord and the things He's done through the people here at Forest Springs, I'm in a better spot. I have so many people here that care for me. And for the first time in so many long years, I can finally say that I am okay.
Thank you, Brady. That was wonderfully written. All right. I'm Ember, for anyone who doesn't know me, and I guess I'll just start. I am a Christian. That is where I place my identity. Not in my friends, not in my grades, not in my gender, not in my sexuality, not in my opinions or political beliefs, not in anything else in the world. I am a child of God, and that is the most important thing in my life. My name is Ember Schmidt. I'm a Trailhead student at Forest Springs, soon to be a first-year student at the University of Eau Claire. I came to Trailhead with no sense of direction, clinging to toxic ideologies of past friends, no idea what to do with the rest of my life. This is a story that's been told over and over again by students across time and space, the story of a lost identity. But unlike most young adults in this day and age, I found it again, and I found it in Jesus Christ. I've always called myself a Christian, but as the years slipped by, I found myself begin to fall away from both myself and my religion. I became a chameleon, taking on the opinions and personalities of the people around me. It reached a point where I was assigned to write a paragraph about my views on a major political issue. In high school, and I found I just couldn't because I didn't have an opinion on it. Instead of just writing something down, I went around interviewing my friends and family about their thoughts on it and conglomerated a paragraph together, tossing their words together instead of mine. After this, I began to think of all the opinions that I really held and came up with next to nothing. Realizing I had no idea who I was terrifying. How does one even begin to dig themselves out of this endless hole that they dug themselves into? How does one begin to build an identity from scratch? But with the help of my best friend, newfound friends, Dan's teaching, professional personality tests, and most importantly, the Bible, I began to slowly rebuild my identity. Not an identity to match the people around me, but an identity in truth and in Christ. Early in my renewed quest for an identity, I found I had a passion for teaching and for learning. I can never seem to get enough new information, and I'm constantly sharing what I've learned. I find so much joy in sharing and teaching, in seeing people learn something new, or see someone understand something they've been previously struggling with. I'm always analyzing different teachers, how they teach, and how the students respond to their teaching style. Reflecting on this has made me realize that at the core of who I am, I'm a learner, I'm a teacher, and I'm an analytic student. Understanding this is what spurred me to go to college for teaching and history. It gave me a sense of direction for the future, something I've never had before. It gave me an amazing sense of peace. In terms of biblical beliefs, I had all the usual church kid knowledge, but none of the passion nor love for Christ. Over the course of the year, I've had my faith renewed through studying history and apologetics, and found my joy to be in Christ through serving and living in a Christian community. I think the most major change in my walk with Christ, though, is that I've learned to trust him with all my anxieties. And I try to live out Philippians 4:6, a verse about not being anxious and giving everything to God. I've lived in a cloud of anxiety my whole life, but whenever I give up a worry to God and focus on his words instead of my own problems, my fears fade away. I hope to use the gifts that God has given me to help guide others. I never want anyone, especially young people, to feel as lost as I did in high school. Feeling alone and without a purpose puts people in dark places, and I hope to be a light to them through Jesus in all I do and say for the rest of my life. I am saved. I am loved, and I am a child of God.
Good morning, LTD and Trailhead students. What a joy it is to celebrate all that you've accomplished today here at Forest Springs. Of course, Laura and I would have loved to have been there with you today, but as you know, our daughter Alyssa is graduating from the University of Dubuque this morning at the same time. We do pray for you guys, and we want you to keep God first in your life. And our Laura and I's favorite verse, life verse together, is Proverbs 3, 5, and 6, which says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight." We pray that for you, and we look forward to hearing what the Lord is going to do in your life. I'm honored this morning to give this prayer dedication for each one of you. And so let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we do thank you for this morning, the time to celebrate these students and all that they have done here. And Lord, as we pray for them, I just thank you for our LTD class, I thank you for Tim and Ashley and just for their heart, for ministry, Lord, how you've led them in life, Lord. I thank you that you have placed it on the heart of Tim to be joining our maintenance team here as a vehicle maintenance specialist, and Ashley as well to continue to serve in the cafe and be a part of the resident program team. Lord, just thank you for their enthusiasm for you and this ministry. Lord, I thank you for Daniel and Abby. We're excited for them that you've drawn them into camp ministry as well. And Lord, as they head to Cedar Bay, we're excited to see how God is going to lead them in their roles as they serve at one of our other locations. Lord, I also thank you for Paul and Carly. What a blessing it is to get to know them. And we're thankful that you have led them into camp ministry as well. And as they head to Arrowhead Bible Camp and serve there, Lord, I just pray that you would guide them along the journey as well. Lord, I also pray for Carly, and they're expecting their first baby here due this next month. Lord, I just ask for protection of this little one, and Lord, just thank you for them. Lord, as I think of our Trailhead students, I'm so thankful to get to know them. Lord, you know them fully, and you know how you're leading them. I pray for Kenya that she'll be working at Timber Bay for the summer, and you continue to lead her and guide her as she serves there. Thank you for Silas and just for his heart. Lord, I know he's pursuing a path and being a lineman. And Lord, I just ask that you would lead in that way, protect him as he works in conditions that can be dangerous. But Lord, I just thank you for him in that way. Lord, I thank you for Daniel. And as he works in a farmer's market this year, I just pray that you would, this coming fall, that you would that would be a good time for him. Lord, I know he has a plan, Lord willing, that he may be back here at Four Springs this fall. And we are excited at that possibility and just pray for your leading in that. Lord, I thank you for Grace. And as she heads back home to move in with some family, brothers and family to help care for her property and the work that she'll be doing there. Lord, I just ask that you would be with her too. Just thank you for the fact she's been here and as she joins up with family to serve this summer, just that would be a good experience for her. Lord, I thank you for Anna. Thank you that for her enthusiasm as well. Lord, and she works this summer here on the waterfront. I pray that you prepare her for her role in serving here this summer. And Lord, you know the plan for her after the summer season. And Lord, maybe it would be serving here or in another direction that you have. But Lord, we know that you're in control and she trusts you in that. Lord, I thank you for Graham. I thank you for him. And Lord, I know he'll be heading to Wood Lake, one of our other camps as well, to serve as a counselor this summer. I thank you for his enthusiasm to be a part of that. And just continue to guide and direct him as he follows you. Lord, Braden, thank you for him as well. I know he's going to be serving here at Four Springs this summer as well as an archery instructor, and I pray that that would be a wonderful experience and an opportunity for him to invest in the campers that are here and the families that'll be here as well. And Lord, I know that you will have a job and a plan for him as he heads back home after this. And Lord, work those details out in his life as well as he also plans to attend college. And Lord, give him wisdom in that as well, particularly as you've been leading him toward maybe pastoral studies and becoming a youth pastor, as you've placed that on his heart. Lord, thank you for Amber. I know she's planning to go to the University of Clare here, and I pray that you would just continue to give her guidance and wisdom in life transition, getting into the college life and all that's happening there. Lord, as she follows your leading in a history emphasis in her degree, that you would just allow opportunities for her to just grow in that as well. Lord, for Cole, I know he's planning to be working camp this summer as well. And Lord, as you lead him into this fall season and going to possibly going to tech school, for welding. I pray that you would just continue to lead and guide him in that endeavor. And thank you for his enthusiasm as well. Lord, thank you for Francesca. And Lord, as she returns home and working in her home area, Lord, I thank you for her and the step of faith she had in coming into this program. And Lord, for however you're leading in her life into the future, that would be clear for her and that she would enjoy being home, back home and serving in her community there. Thank you for Lauren. And Lord, we know she has a desire to be back, maybe serving even at some point or another this Forest Springs here this summer. And Lord, if that be your will, that would work out, Lord. And then after that, pursuing college and entering into a new time of life, Lord, that you would just give direction for her in that as well. So, Lord, we thank you so much for each one of these students. We thank you for how you have led them here, the joys, the challenges, the experiences they've had here. And Lord, we know that in everything that they have done here has been all pointed to and growing in you, in their relationship with you. And we ask that would continue to happen as they depart from this program here. So we thank you for all of these things in your precious name. Amen.
All right, we're going to give the Trailhead certificates and the paddles. So Ben and Kat are going to come up. And it's not just because there's too much to do that we've got them up here, because it's with intentionality that Ben and Kat will give the certificates. There isn't anyone that has been more important, if you are a parent or family member of a Trailhead student, to them this year than these two. And I don't know what I did to be blessed with these two to work with, but I could have been run over by a bus in October, and this thing would have just gone on as planned. These two are amazing, and so I desire purposefully for you to give their certificates. Yeah. And then we have paddles up here. They've made these paddles, and it's kind of handy for us that we give them something, but we made them make it, so it didn't cost us anything. There's actually some meaning in this, and so I just want to just briefly explain what the paddles are about and a little bit of a charge to you guys. Paddle, of course, can be a noun, right? You know your parts of speech. Paddle is a noun, okay? I could hand you the paddle, okay? And the meaning in handing you the paddle is to point out to you that you guys are at a place in life where your parents still want to help you, and hopefully you'll let them. And we still would love to help you, and hopefully you'll let us. But you're kind of at the place in life where if you're not paddling your boat, so to speak, it's pretty hard now for anybody else to do that for you. And so there's responsibility for you just to consider as we hand you the paddle. It's like handing you the keys to the car, Brady, right? A little bit, right? So as you receive the paddle, just think of that you've been given some responsibility here. This from here on out, the bigger decisions that will affect you will be made by you. Okay. Paddle is also a verb, right? And so it can be like an imperative verb, like you're drifting away and we yell at you, paddle, right? And I want to talk about what we don't want this to look like for you. And Paul, really conveniently in Ephesians 4, uses a boating metaphor for immaturity in the body of Christ. I'll read it to you. He talks about being children, tossed to and fro by the waves and carried about by every wind of doctrine, by human cunning, by craftiness and deceitful schemes. So picture the lake, and the lake is choppy. There's wind and there's waves, and we're yelling at you to paddle, but it's tough because all these ideas, the social media ideas and the music you listen to and your friends and the culture that you'll be living in. Ember, there's lots of waves at Eau Claire. I've been there. And immaturity in the body of Christ is that they just take you wherever they're going to take you, okay? And Paul is saying we don't want to be like that. And I'm going to give you just two quick points. Where this is going to happen and what it's going to look like. When it comes to how to survive the waves, here's what Paul says. God gave us the apostles, the prophets, evangelists, the shepherds, the teachers, to equip the saints, that's you, for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ until we all attain to the unity of faith, to the knowledge of the Son of God, to mature manhood, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, so that we may no longer be children, right? There's an assumption that Paul makes there, right? And that is that you have shepherds in your life. And so where are you going to be equipped to do the work of ministry? You're going to need to be part of the body of Christ. You have to get yourself into a good church. We provide church consulting here, okay? Anytime you want. If you move to a new town and you just want to talk about where should I go, but please consider this step number one. In paddling your own boat, connect yourself to the body of Christ and to some real people in that body who will help you to be equipped to do the work of ministry. And what does the work of ministry look like? As we grow in the body of Christ, here's what he says. He says, rather, instead of being tossed about and blown away by the wind, rather speaking the truth, and then what? In love, right? How many times have we talked about this year? As the ideas are coming and you're trying to figure out how to handle this, and your generation just wants to love, and you're not sure if the truth matters. That's not what Paul says. Paul says, you're going to grow together by speaking the truth. And how will you speak it? In love, right? So can we just do love is like asking, can I just paddle on one side of the canoe? You can. You'll go in circles, and you'll never make it to maturity, okay? So as you paddle, please keep that in mind. Truth in love. And you'll grow up into him who is the head, into Christ, Paul says, as the body of Christ. So those are my two. That's my last crack at you from 8 months, okay? Connect yourself to the body of Christ. And when you're encountering the confusion, speak the truth in love. And you'll grow up into him, okay? So when we hand you your paddle, that's the message, all right? So Kat and Ben will read the names and give the certificates, and Norm and I will try to remember whose paddle is whose. Why don't you just actually grab it as you come by, okay?
Kenya Anderson.
Silas Bowles. Daniel Burchell.
Grace Burrs.
Great job.
Anna Kolstock.
Graham Frederick. Braden Metke.
Ember Schmidt.
Cole Van Gorp.
Francesca Vincent. Lauren Wheatman.
LTD, this is now your turn. We've had a lot of goals in LTD, and these guys have done a great job. I think all the way back from when Dick started this program, the vision that God gave him, and through the years, all the transitions that have happened, it's evident this year, and you guys are evidence of this. But today we give you these diplomas, but like Dan was just saying, there's so much more for you, and I'm trusting that one of the words I've used is that through this program, through your time in the Word, through your time seeing it modeled here, that you guys will leave being resilient followers of Christ as leaders. And I say resilient because it's similar to what Dan was saying, is that no matter where you're going to be in the next year, the next 5 years, the next 10 years, there's going to be challenges all around you that will want to distract you. And I'm praying that this year, all the stuff that we've done, writing those papers, has made you think through philosophy of ministry, through program, and through how do we do staffing, how do we pay for it, who are your board members, what do they do, all these things have created a foundation for you to think clearly, but to think biblically, to think with grace, to think with mercy, but to become resilient followers of Christ, because there's a lot of challenges ahead of you. And I know I share this with the staff here at Four Springs and with Dick and Pat and John, that what a great testimony it'll be 5 years, 10 years from now, that you're still with your hand to the plow, doing what God has called you to do, whether it's here at Four Springs or up at Cedar or Arrowhead or wherever God is going to take you. And so that's our prayer for you, and it all ends today, and I have these certificates up here. First of all, first one is Timothy Lee Burkholder. Come on up, Tim. Your grades are here. Tim got grades. They're good. And this is for Abigail Furno, Mrs. Furno. Great job. Her grades are in here too. My sister and my oldest brother had perfect grades. I'm glad to say there's another person who had perfect grades. Perfect. And your husband, Abby. Daniel Furneaux, come on up here. And last, not least, but the tallest and the biggest, Paul Bradley. McKeon, come on up here. Great job, Paul. We're doing another worship session, right?
Yes.
Yes. Here we go.
Sorry, I got a lot of stuff up here to do. Our Trailhead have really enjoyed singing together this year, and so we didn't want to complete this celebration without allowing them to share their beautiful voices with us. So if you want to stand and join us and sing, feel free to do so.
Our King, come let us bow at His feet. done great things. Oh God, you do great things.
You guys can go ahead and take a seat. As soon as the Trailhead are seated, we can go ahead and we've got a special video to play.
There is a world outside, so why do I hide when you tell me I am free? I see the open door, yeah, I know there's more, but I've been too scared to leave.
Going out in the storm, but if you really hold me tight, All the way home, I'll be warm.
I feel good. I knew I wouldn't. I feel good. I knew that I wouldn't. So good. So good. I got you.
Well, we'll just say this, it looked like a great year, right? And it was, indeed. To everybody in the room, the last thing I'll say, as these guys head out, pray for us. We've got, by Labor Day, a whole other Trailhead group will show up. I think there'll be maybe 13, 14, 15, 20 kids. I don't know what Dan has, how crazy Dan wants to get. And a whole other group of Trailhead, of LTD students. Interestingly, this year, we've got a ton of international students that are coming. We're trying to get them through the visa process right now, and it's arduous, but keep praying for that. And lastly, I would say, this is tremendous. What we just celebrated is tremendous. And each one of you in the room, you're one of the best promotion people we have for God to do this in other people's lives, in Trailhead and LTD preparing for ministry. So please, no matter where you go for the next 100 years, talk about what we do, because God can use this program to do great things, as you've seen. So as soon as we're done here, there'll be a meal served at noon next door. So let's close the time of prayer, and I'll pray for that food too. So let's pray. Lord, thank you for this time. It has been a great celebration. And thank you, Lord, that at this place, we want to give you the credit. At this place, with all that Trailhead has been through in LTD, that we proclaim Christ. We proclaim Christ as the answer to everything, that as long as we focus on you, we'll be able to paddle, we'll be able to lead, and we'll be able to influence this world in the name of Jesus until you come or you take us, Lord. And so please, bless all this work and this effort in your name. So, Lord, we thank you for the staff that has prepared food. Again, they've prepared food for us, and may we enjoy it and give you the thanks for it. Go with us now as we go a lot of different directions, Lord. And in your name we pray, in Jesus' name, amen. Thank you. Already said, oh, I'll get an email. He's
okay.
So Graham's dad. Yeah. No. And I'm not gonna ask.
So it is
11:50.
Yeah, 11:50. Perfect timing.
Putting up with him. Yeah. Thanks for coming all this way.
That was good meeting you, and I love seeing this beautiful place and where my people are. So I'm glad we got up here.
Fantastic. Well, we always say you never visit this place once.
Amen.
So somewhere, for some reason,
You'll be back.
There you go.
And I maybe many so. Times. So
Yeah, we'll stay for lunch. I wanted to get a picture with you.
I wanted to get a picture with you too.
Thanks for representing Grantsburg.
Thank you.
Yes.
Leadership.
It's been easy this year. Yeah.
Too easy.
Well. Yeah. Great.
Yeah.
I might get that 4.0.
Yeah.
Thank you, Norm. Appreciate it.
It was great. Great to be with us.
Look forward to seeing you. Frederick to here, which is like a 3-hour drive, but they stop overnight at Arrowhead.
Frederick to Arrowhead.
Are you guys going to do it this year? Are you guys going to do the tour of the forest from Oak to here? Get your electric bike.
Hey, we have e-bikes now.
Yeah.
How many people do you
have? Oh, like 10 to 15.
Our camp director's like, so how many people? And I was like, no more than 20. Because I got somebody who's like, make this 100 riders. I was like, no.